speed you have. The read on the speed meter says you have to go to task in the city, where people drown and people serve. Don't be shy, you just deserve. It's only just light years to go. Me, my thoughts are flowers strewn, ocean storm may bury me. I have got to leap to find my way. Watch the road and memorize the slide that passed before my eyes. Nothing is going my way. The ocean is a river's goal. Need to leave, the water knows. We're closer now than light years to go. To find the river, Bergamot, Bedever, run through my head and fall away. Leave the road and memorize this life that passed before my eyes. Nothing is going my way.
Answer Beth Blue here. I do have to say one more thing about your wrecks. Okay, so I'm used to diving on metal heaps that have disintegrated because of salt water, but your wrecks are wooden wrecks, and I hate to coin this expression, but they give me a woody thinking about the fact that I'm going to get to dive on a fully intact wreck that looks exactly like it was when it first sank. Dives only. We are not divers with a drinking problem or drinkers with a diving problem. There are clubs like that, but we do know how to socialize, and we have a good time. Go.
You can see the logo there. Nice product placement. Right where everything is, all of us male divers like logos to be.
Everybody, welcome back to Talking Scuba. I'm Bob Shoemaker, the awesomest diver ever.
And I'm Jim Norton, a dive con.
Hey, everybody, you see our new set? We've got we got tanks, we've got some cool stuff, we've got sorts of shells, and my favorite part, the liquor shelf.
Our the treasure.
Oh, we all have our favorites. Keegan, we are, once we did figure out we were bullshitting with each other, and then all of a sudden the tire blew out, we pulled off to the side of the road, realized we didn't quite have the right jack, and it was kind of a nightmare. Oh, once we did get it off, that's what she said, and we were able to with a sledgehammer after calling your brother and your wife and having them all come out, we finally got that damn thing off.
Oh, yeah. It was a good thing for my wife. She can really swing a hammer.
Yeah, he got it. Now, you guys can also fiscally support the show now. Keep us on the air. With a donation of $5 or more, you can get a sticker sent to you. If you are interested, you can get that through our email or on our Facebook page. And for a donation of $20 or more, I will personally autograph your breasts. So thanks for stopping by, and to the next dive.
To the next dive.
I guess a lot of times, too, a tiger shark will show up, but this time of year is when their mating season, I guess, and so they're off doing their thing elsewhere, so we don't see any of them.
That would suck if you could only mate once a year.
Well, probably better than some people do.
That's true. At least you know for sure you're getting it once a year. To the next
guys, have a good one.
Bottoms up.
Jesus. Jim had a rough week.
Yes.
You're a tough SOB, aren't you?
Getting tougher by the minute.
Be more in control using your breathing, which I think is really important, especially if you're going to get into, you know, more of the technical diving where you're doing penetration dives, whether it be caves or wrecks or anything. Get a chance to dive some different gear, do it. It can totally affect you in ways you might not expect. So, and to the next dive.
To the next dive.
I hope Judy's coming to get you.
Good stuff.
Oh my God.
She's looking at you, Ma.
Every last drop.
That was a full bottle before we started today.
Yep, now you could drink another one.
Hey, Jim, you want to drive us to lunch?
Sure. I'm ready.
So, like, my favorite thing in the world besides drinking, even more than drinking, is definitely scuba diving.
Oh, definitely.
I love it so much. I dream about it. I had a nice dream last night about finding a spring.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. And it's just all the time. That's all I think about. Me and Derek were talking the other day. He's getting the same way. Derek got trained a couple of years ago, and then he moved away. Wasn't able to do a lot of scuba diving. Now it's Saturday today, and he's like, man, I haven't been diving at all. And he's like, I dove Wednesday, and that's it. So he's kind of upset about diving. It's just the way you get it. Just get it into your blood, and you're just obsessed with it.
A lot of fun.
And going and take over the whole U.S.
And now, as you can see, it is night out, and we got these two douchebags are wearing their sunglasses because the sun never does set on a badass. I don't know if you guys know that or not. But we do have some giggling girls that are running around here. Did they take off?
That's because when I show them my tan lines,
it gets
worse. With a stick.
That's true. The girls love the raccoon lines. All right, Mike.
One of my favorite spots was the Straits.
Yeah, absolutely.
The Straits up in Mackinac. We had some excellent weather, excellent visibilities, no current. Dove a couple of wrecks I'd never dove before. One of them was the Stalker, which went down in the 1800s. I believe it was a bark. I'm not sure. But we could penetrate it a bit. And it's on one of our videos.
Absolutely, yeah.
I think it's on the second one, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. And that was one of my favorite wrecks because I think that's where Johnny got stuck.
Yes,
is that where you got stuck, Johnny?
Yes.
We're diving along, and I go through the first cabin, and then it gets a little narrow in a spot. And I was like, man, I hope Johnny's not right behind me. And then turns out we look at the footage afterwards, and sure enough, the video stops. Johnny's swimming along, and all of a sudden, it just stops. So, Johnny got stuck in one spot, but we got him out. You know, he's here today, so we got lucky there.
And Johnny got to learn some new hand signals.
That's right. Good. I know Derek and a couple of the other guys, we're diving just the backpacks now, and it's such a streamlined system and stuff like that. We get really excited about diving some of that old gear.
Absolutely, and it makes it a little hard for the rest of us to keep up with you guys.
Yeah. Well, Derek, you know, he's about the size of a barracuda anyways. He swims through the water.
Well, that's what we call him, is Cuda.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, you streamline him anymore, he just moves right along on you. But, you know, we get to dive some of that old gear, but I also got the opportunity to go to somewhere with my friends Patrick and Bridget. Bridget?
Hey!
Yeah. She's a contender for the number one fan this year. But anyways, we got to go to Bonaire this year.
Oh, some of the footage you got of that was outstanding.
It was such an awesome time there. We got to hang out with my favorite fish, the tarpon.
Oh, yeah.
That was one of my favorite dives of all time. The only time I've ever really screwed up on my air consumption. I got so excited chasing those damn things around. I was swimming behind them, and they come up, and what we're doing is at night, you have your light out, right? And you're following these fish, and these tarpon swim right along with you. They use you as bait, kind of. Yeah, yeah.
Kind of a chumming friend.
Right, right.
So they see your light and you flash onto a fish, and those tarpon swim up next to you and they go, whoo, and they eat the fish that you just shined with your light. So you can kind of play God, right? And you can, it's a lot of fun. So, you know, that was one of my favorite times this year that I've had, so. One of my favorite parts that I didn't mention about Bonaire is definitely diving with the hooker down there.
You had a hooker down there?
Absolutely. One of the greatest wrecks they have in Bonaire is called the Hilma Hooker. So we had several opportunities to go down on the hooker, and big clams down on there, a lot of big fish. It was a really great shipwreck dive. So one of my favorite places to dive.
So anyways, my life has changed this week.
Tell me, how?
I started diving in backplate really similar to this one.
Really?
Just a backplate, no BC. It's not like we just did shallow dives. We did some deeper dives, about 60, 70 foot. I was really comfortable. I don't know if it's for everybody, but man, I just felt so much more comfortable.
So were you kind of neutral, buoyant?
Yeah, I was.
Hey, drop us a line, little email once in a while. Let us know if we're doing good, bad, or indifferent.
Yeah, and the bad ones, you can send those right to jim@talking-scuba.com.
Or Johnny B.
Or Johnny B.
Johnny loves those.
Johnny likes the bad ones.
Yep.
I like all the love letters. So for all you beautiful ladies out there, you can send those to bob@talking-scuba.com, and I'm excited to hear from those girls.
Ladies this time.
To the next dive. Cheers. And to the next dive.
To the next dive.
And cheers to the next drink.
To the next dive.
Have a good one.
Bottoms up.
And to the next dive.
To the next dive.
Bottoms up.
Bottoms up.
To the next dive.
To the next dive.
Cheers.
To the next dive.
To the next dive. Cheers.
Hey, you guys. Cheers and to the next dive.
Oh, what? Just
a second. I always forget something.
Yep. This is a special thanks.
Oh.
The lady that flashed us Thursday night.
Oh! Thanks for your boobs, lady.
To the next dive.
To the next dive.
Again, to the next dive.
To the next dive.
To the next dive.
Cheers.
Jim?
To the next dive.
To the next dive. Cheers.
And to the next dive.
To the next dive.
Jim, to the next dive.
To the next dive.
Cheers.
And to the next dive.
To the next dive.
To the next dive.
To the next dive.
Cheers.